Good morning. Are you well?
How
are you doing?
I'm good. Nice to meet you.
Hi, I'm T. How are you doing? Hello. You good?
Oh, well, it's freezing, so I'd love to get inside.
Please
I'm very
do.
Excited to be here.
Oh, good man.
Come I love the, what you do. Oh, yes. Now you're talking.
Thank you.
Wow. God. Look at that.
That is superb.
Wow. That's amazing.
How old's that?
It's 1898.
That's got a Springer front end before motorbikes had it then.
Indeed.
Way before.
Correct.
Is that the rarest bike here?
There's only probably five in this country. So it's quite a rare machine.
What would it cost you today to buy one of those?
7,000 would buy 7, it today. Wow.
It's a work of art. It's sculptural,
it is.
Isn't it?
It's very...
Just hang it on the wall.
Yes.
One bike that struck me the second I walked in was a bike called a Victor. It's everything I like about old items. It's phenomenally well designed. It's quirky, it's different, and it's exciting to see. Ooh, I know what that is. That I love. That's the beginning of cycling. That's the birth of cycling right there. So what age is that?
1869, English.
Wow. So that would have been made by a Cartwright.
Yes.
Bicycles, they weren't called bicycles, they were bone shakers, weren't they? Bone shakers. I've got to ask, what's that worth? A lot.
A lot.
Everywhere you look here, there are rare bikes. Now, these are bikes where there'll be a handful left in the world. We open one shed door and he's got a real bone shaker. A real one from the 19th century. Incredible thing.
The bone shaker was one of the first types of bicycle with pedals. It was invented in the 1860s in France and manufactured by the Michaud Company, who referred to it as a velocipede. It's earned its nickname due to the extremely uncomfortable ride because of the wrought iron frame and wooden wheels with iron tires. Few originals exist today, as most were melted down for the metal during World War I. Today, a bone shaker could sell for around £5,000.
Two things not original. The seat.
Yep.
Because the mice had eaten the seat.
Yep.
And two spokes in the front wheel, which I broke in a race.
And that's it. You raced,
you raced it.
I did.
You're my new hero now.
Eh? World Championship Bone Shaker Race.
That's fantastic. Paul's enthusiasm for bikes is infectious. You walk in here, I defy anybody, even if you're not interested in bikes, to walk in here and not go, wow, that's exciting. And the range he's got in here is phenomenal.
Although Paul wouldn't want to part with his rare bikes...
Where are we going now?
Bottom end.
There are things here he'd be happy to sell.
Oh, yeah, now you're talking. Great sign.
You like?
Yeah, I like everything here. I like that.
Do you?
Yes.
What have we spotted?
That lamp, look at that.
Ah.
You've put that on it?
I did. It's a fire engine search lamp.
Yeah. Great base. It's just I've had that base before.
Ah.
Just a normal industrial machinist's.
Yes, yes.
That's fantastic. There's work to do. It's been painted a horrible colour with Nafal paint, which we'll have to strip that right back to the steel. There's a bend in it, it's going to have to be fixed, and also it's going to have to be rewired. So there's not an easy one, needs work, but it looks great. And what we do is really find things that look great.
This light, once restored and rewired, could have a value of £600.
Would that be something you want to sell?
Yeah, I think so, yeah.
Go on then, hit us with a price. You're obviously very good at buying and selling stuff, so.
I'm not, actually.
You must, really?
No, I'm awful.
Oh, you just go, I've got to have it?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Like you.
There is some judgment involved, but it's slim.
Minimal.
Minimal. No, I love it. Love it. I'd be really, really interested in that. So what would it take to buy it?
400.
Too much. Starting point. Starting point. I'm gonna go straight in with my best offer then.
Yes.
£200.
How's 2.5?
I don't want to argue over £50, really, but...
Good.
You said you were no good at this.
I'm not.
It's better than me today. I'm having an off day. I'm having an off week, actually, aren't I?
Yeah. Don't play poker.
I'm a rank outsider when you go
to this. Oh, dear. 225. Sold. Thank you.
Having made his first purchase, Drew's keen to have a rummage in the storerooms.
So in this one?
Yep, go in that.
So what's this then, junk storage?
Yeah, basically, overflow, yes.
Overflow.
Uncontrolled overflow.
Are these yours?
Yes, sir.
I'd be keen on those.
Would you? I think they're chapel chairs.
They are chapel chairs with the little Bible. Now, these, I used to buy thousands of these a year and they've dried up.
Ah?
You can't get them anymore. They're hard to get hold of.
Well, you could get some today.
Yeah, they've had the... There's a lot of damage.
On that one as well.
There's a lot of damage on them. Still, they're nice shape.
Yeah.
Very simplistic. All the stretchers are broken on all of them. They've been cut off there, there, there and there.
These early 20th century chapel house chairs are made from beech. After restoration, they could be worth £60 each.
What would you want for them?
I don't know.
I know what I usually pay for them.
Well, give me a clue.
In good condition, 25 to 35 quid each.
Yes.
These aren't so good. Those would be £15 a chair.
Because that sounds good.
Yeah. Because they sound a bit...
That sounds good.
Do you have a deal on? Yeah. I'll take them as many as you've got.
Yes.
The ones with the missing stretchers will have to have all the stretchers remade, put back in, re-glued, patinated to match the other pieces. So it's not a straightforward, easy sale. But I've hardly got any for sale at the moment, so I've got no choice. I've got to buy them.
After a bit more digging, Drew finds a total of 16 chairs.
Tea?
Yeah.
I made a bit of a mess of this. I got overexcited. We can't get out.
Do we need to ring someone?
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's lovely.
Will it fit?
I don't think so. It looks really small. I like these.
Do you?
I do. Got a vintage race car.
Ah.
And I want one to sort of have on display in the
car.
Well,
there you are, you see. You've just found it.
This open-face helmet was made by British company Stadium Limited in the 1960s and could have a value of £40.
That's the one that preempted it. There.
Yeah, that's the corker.
That's it. Sterling Moss, when he did the Millimelia with Jenks.
Correct, yes.
Wore one of these.
He did.
And didn't he average 130 miles an hour for 20 hours or something?
With that.
With one of these, and yeah. Said, when men were men.
Or stupid.
This helmet, known as the Corker because of the 5mm cork lining, was made by J. Compton, Sons and Webb in London in the 1950s. It could be worth £50.
It's laughable, really, because it's a crash helmet made out of cork. If your head comes off, it'll float. I mean, that's all it's used for. It's utterly useless. The other one is a bit more modern. It's from the 60s. Now, I've got a historic race car, so that's going to look really good just in the pits, on the back seat. It's just a period extra that I really love. That's nice. I like this. What would you want for it, Paul?
Not a lot.
Give us a clue.
10 quid.
Oh.
Eh?
30 quid.
You're embarrassed.
30 quid.
Sorry.
Yeah. This one as well.
Yes?
I like the look of. Same price as that one?
Yes, sir. Good man.
Thank you.
Good man.
Display only.
It's a corker.
It's a corker.
It's a corker.
Before they leave, Drew and T can't resist trying out a few of the more unusual bikes.
Right, let's see how dangerous we can make this.
Speed bump.
T attempts the 1869 Bone Shaker.
All right. Right, you're on your own.
Thank you. Oh, I don't want to be on my own. This isn't nice.
Whilst Drew has a slightly smoother ride on the rarest bike in Paul's collection, the 1898 Victor.
It's fantastic!
Can you stop? That's the question.
I'm stopping. I managed to buy some chapel chairs, which are always saleable. They need work, but, you know, hey-ho. Bought two crash helmets for my old cars to have lying on the back seats, so they're not going to get sold. And we did buy a very, very funky industrial lamp with a brass searchlight on top of it, which we'll fully restore, and that'll sell well. That'll pay for my day messing about with old bikes. All finished?
Yep, all in.
Cool. Paul, a pleasure.
Thank you
so much.
Very enjoyable day.
Great day.
Thank you.
Loved it.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you so much.